In today's video, we are going to show you how to create pre-recorded webinars with WebinarGeek. We'll cover both automated and on-demand webinars. We will also talk about hybrid webinars, a combination of live and pre-recorded content. This topic might sound familiar because we discussed it a long time ago on this channel, but we've updated it with some new features and more details to help you get the most out of your webinars. Whether you want your webinars available at any time or a mix of live and recorded content, WebinarGeek makes it super easy to reach your audience. So let's get started. What are pre-recorded webinars? Before we jump into the steps, let's quickly explain what we mean by pre-recorded webinars. Pre-recorded webinars are sessions that you create and record in advance. You can make them available in two ways. The first one is automated webinars. Automated webinars play automatically at set times. These webinars are perfect for when you want to repeat your content often. Let's say for product demos or regular training sessions. The second one are on-demand webinars. These webinars are available at any time. Once you have uploaded your on-demand webinar, your audience can watch them at any time. Both types are great for when you want to share your content with a large audience or reach teams around the world. They are perfect for creating detailed product demos, training sessions, or educational series. Creating your pre-recorded webinar. Now let's set up your first pre-recorded webinar, and all you have to do is follow these easy steps. So, log into WebinarGeek, click on Create New Webinar, and now choose either automated or on-demand webinar. Automated webinars, as I just explained, are webinars that are set to play at a specific time. On-demand webinars are available at any time. For now, we are choosing on-demand webinar. Now let's upload your recorded webinar. You have multiple options. You can record your webinar directly inside of WebinarGeek, and this is great if you want to create an automated or on-demand webinar quickly and easily. After you have your recording, you can convert it into an automated session or on-demand webinar. Or you can upload your own video. Let's say if you already have recorded your webinar using another software, you can upload your video to WebinarGeek. The platform supports a variety of video formats, making the upload process smooth and straightforward. And your last option, if you've previously hosted a live webinar and you want to reuse the recording, you can select it directly from your past webinars and use it as the video for your new automated or on-demand session. But for this on-demand webinar, I'm going to choose a recording that I've already made. And even though your webinar is pre-recorded, you can still make it interactive to keep your audience engaged. You can use quizzes and polls. So add a quiz to test what your viewers have learned. For example, you can add a quiz at the end of a training session. Or you can add a call to action. After the webinar, include a call to action. This encourages viewers to sign up for other sessions, schedule a demo, or download a resource. So now we have set up an on-demand webinar from a previous recording, and we've added a call to action and a quiz. An introduction to hybrid webinars. Now let's talk about hybrid webinars, a combination of live and pre-recorded content. With a hybrid webinar, you can stream live sessions while showing pre-recorded content, you can have live discussions and Q&A sessions while playing videos, and you can share videos and still interact with your audience in real time during your live session. Hybrid webinars are a great way to keep things interactive while still having the flexibility of pre-recorded content. You can easily use WebinarGeek's hybrid feature to create this kind of dynamic experience. Post-webinar follow-up. After your webinar is finished, don't forget to follow up with your audience. Here's what you can do. And the first one, send follow-up emails. You can send a link to the recording, key takeaways, and extra resources. This is especially important for on-demand webinars, as they can be watched at any time. And the second one, send surveys. Collect feedback from your viewers so you can use that to improve your webinars in the future. With WebinarGeek's automation features, follow-up emails can be sent right after your webinar has ended. The best practices for pre-recorded and hybrid webinars. And at last, here are some tips to get the best result out of your pre-recorded webinars or hybrid webinars. And the first one, keep it short and engaging. Break your content into smaller sections. Keep it clear and simple to hold the attention. And the second one, use visuals. Visuals can help make your webinar look more interesting. So definitely include slides, images, and of course, videos. And the third one, promote your webinar. Share it on social media and via email to get more viewers. especially important if you have on-demand webinars. And finally, repurpose your content. You can repurpose your webinars in many different ways. This is also a great way to reach a new audience. So that's how easy it is to set up pre-recorded and hybrid webinars within WebinarGeek. Whether you choose automated webinars or on-demand webinars, or combine live with pre-recorded content in the form of a hybrid webinar, WebinarGeek makes it super easy to create professional and engaging webinars to reach your audience. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video and you want to learn more about webinars on how to host them, what gear to use, and what it's like to work at a tech startup, subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click like on this video and hit that notification bell. And let me know, do you already host pre-recorded webinars? Thank you so much for watching and see you on the next one. Bye!